back to my channel, or hi if you're new here. My name is Emma. I make videos. I post every Sunday 8 o'clock, so if you're not subscribed to my channel, you can go down below and do that. So if you've noticed on my channel, I've been leaning towards more advice-based videos, and I thought that I would keep that going again this week with 10 ways to get and to stay inspired. Keep in mind that these are all ways that I would personally use to get and stay motivated, so some of them might not work for you, but they personally do work for me. So one of the first things that I would do if I'm feeling kind of down and I want to get amped up for the day or for a sport or working on homework or anything like that, then I would turn on some music. Now I can have a song that's just kind of like my anthem, which for me personally right now, it's This Is Me from The Greatest Showman, and then my playlist that I like to listen to is a musicals playlist because I'm obsessed with musicals. So as you can see on my Spotify, I have Grease Live, Hamilton, Singy Songs, which is a compilation of a whole bunch of songs that I like to sing, Glee Cast, Radio, The Greatest Showman, and then like Pentatonix and stuff are my top five, or I don't know if that was five, but my top couple. So yeah, if I want to get and stay motivated, I turn on some tunes so that I can pump up the jams, and it makes me feel really good to just have that song or that playlist playing because it just makes me happier already and I feel more motivated to get stuff done. So something that really works for me when I want to get inspired is I make a vision board. Now I can do that the crafty way, which I've done a couple times, actually printing out pictures, putting it all onto a board, or I can also do it the other way, easy way, on Pinterest, which is what I generally do for things. You can pick out a couple pictures that you like, make a board with it on Pinterest, and then anytime that you're like, what was it about this that I really liked, you can go back to your vision board and scroll through all of them. But the thing about Pinterest to remember when you're making a vision board or something, most of those are staged pictures, so don't feel down if your life doesn't look perfect like your vision board, because it's not supposed to. I mean, imagine the people right after they take that picture on Pinterest. They probably didn't keep it that way for long. They probably drank their thing and then they had a dirty cup sitting there or whatever. Like, life isn't gonna look perfect like Pinterest is what I'm getting at. So if you're feeling down and you wanna get amped up and motivated, you can listen to a podcast, a TED Talk, a YouTube video, all about getting motivated. We've actually been watching a lot of TED Talks at my school recently, and I really like that because we get to see a lot of people's perspectives on a lot of different things, and after I watch them, I feel inspired by those people. And especially now that I'm a part of YouTube, well, I've been a part of YouTube for like 2 years, but whatever. So I like to watch my fellow YouTubers and watch their inspiring videos. So one of my favorite one of my favorite people to watch is my friend Hannah, and she's a YouTuber also, and I just like watching her videos because they're very motivational and inspiring to me. This one can sound sort of silly to some people, but if you're like me, then you'll understand why. So if I'm feeling like I just can't get anything done, then I'm gonna take a break and go make some coffee. Coffee specifically, or caffeinated tea, because of the caffeine in it. And caffeine has actually been proven to show that it stimulates your brain and can make you want to work harder. But also, for some people, this doesn't work and it can make them feel angsty or whatever. So if you have that issue, I would not go for the caffeine. Probably switch to decaf, actually. So if I'm working on a project, probably for school, or just have a lot of things jumbled up in my head that I don't really know what to do with, then I like to make lists. If I have all this stuff packed up in my brain, swirling around, I can't really focus on the things that I need to do first, so I'm gonna make a list with it. And that's what I generally do, and I can show you a couple examples, like the one that I'm using for this video. I make bullet-pointed lists, or not bullet pointed list, you can write paragraphs if that's what you feel like doing. So you can make a list as extra and as pretty as you want if you're into that sort of thing like I am sometimes, or you can just scratch it all down on a paper, write some bullets like that, so that you can just get everything that's jumbled up in your head and write it down on paper so you can see everything that you need. So through all of the craziness of life, sometimes if you're looking for inspiration, you just need to chill out. You can take a walk, take a bath, or just like sit in silence for a little bit. I like that for me especially. It's because all of this stuff, like I was saying, is jumbling around in my head and I just can't figure out exactly what I need to do. If I've already written my list and I'm not ready to just start on it yet, I'll just take a couple minutes, close my eyes, breathe, think through it, and then get my work done. And I think that that's really inspiring to me. It's because once I can just take a minute and breathe or go on a walk or take a bath, just chill out for a minute, it'll help me because then I'm ready to be rejuvenated and then ready to do my task or whatever it is that I need to do that day. So this next one goes along with staying inspired. Once you've done something and you know that you still have more to do. If you've done something, you should reward yourself, whether that means going on a short break or, I don't know, eating some chocolate or something, but just reminding yourself to reward yourself when you do something good so that you're motivated to keep doing good. Almost like training a dog, but training your mind and training yourself. So the last way that I have for you guys to get inspired is to try something new, whether that's a new sport or a new craft or reading a new book or something like that. Because when you're doing this new thing, something in it might spark creativity and might make you feel inspired to continue doing new things or to doing whatever task you specifically need to be inspired for, I guess. So that will be it for this video. If you liked it, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below if you're not. Also, my Instagram name is in the description box below, so you should go check that out if you haven't done that. So that's everything for this video, and I will see you guys next Sunday at 8 o'clock. Bye.